weird. Hey, it's your birthday. You shouldn't be worrying about the party.
No.
Bye, Mom.
Bye, hon. Look, Mama, I gotta run. I'll see you tonight, birthday girl.
Let's go.
Okay, in a sec. Anissa, do you want a ride?
No, Heather's picking me up. Have you seen my history notes?
In the family room on top of the TV.
Oh, what would I do without you?
It's me. See you later.
Hello? Hi, Dr. Gutierrez. She just left. Hold on a sec. I'll see if I can catch her. Mom! Dr. Gutierrez is on the phone.
Oh, darn. I was supposed to call her back about the Women's League luncheon.
Mary, come on. Gotta
tell her I'll call her back when I get to work.
For the weekend or what?
Well, I haven't exactly asked my mom yet.
Anissa, everybody's going.
Yeah. I know. It's just that I have to wait until she's in a really good mood so she'll say yes.
It's not like we're going to the moon. I mean, it's only Long Beach.
Well, to my mom, that's the moon.
Hey, are you okay?
Yeah, sure. I guess I just overdid it.
Hey, come on. Let's get you changed. Okay, come on.
I'll get you some water.
No, no, I'm okay, really. Let's go to the mall.
Okay. Oh, here it is. 1752. Okay, no problem. Bye, Tony.
Dr. Gutierrez is on the private line.
Oh, yeah, thanks.
Oh, here I am.
Francis, hi.
Yeah, I'm sorry I didn't get back to you sooner. This morning has just been crazy. Anyway, I have all the info for the luncheon.
Oh. Well, what is it then?
I see.
Well, what's exactly the problem? All right. Okay. We'll be there within the half hour. Okay. Okay? I don't know. Abe.
What's up?
Abe, Francis Gutierrez just phoned.
Yeah?
She said the results from Anissa's checkup show some irregularity and she wants to see us right away.
What kind of irregularity?
I don't know. She didn't discuss it on the phone.
Okay, let's go.
She's just a child. 16 years old.
Mary, don't. They could have made a mistake. Couldn't they? I mean, all the time they make mistakes.
It's leukemia.
Is she gonna die?
Oh, some types of leukemia respond very well to treatment.
And other types?
No.
No.
Oh, Mary.
Mary, please.
Please, let's not jump to conclusions. We have to do a series of tests to determine exactly what type of leukemia we're dealing with, okay?
Okay.
Tell Miss Truck to be ready by tomorrow afternoon. You take care of things there. Everything's okay at the shop. Mary, let's call off the party.
Anissa would know that something is wrong. Just go and get the chips, okay? Anything.
Mary.
I'm okay. Just go and get the chips. I'm okay.
Hi there. Where were you?
I only had one period at lunch, English, and we were just going to review stuff. So Heather, Jenny, Claudine, and me just took the afternoon off.
It's no big deal, Mom. I'm way ahead in English. We had lunch at the mall, and then we went shopping.
Sounds great. You want something to eat?
No lecture? What's going on?
Nothing. I just have a lot on my mind with everybody coming tonight. Do you want a sandwich?
I'm not hungry. Look what I've got. You like? They were both half price. I couldn't decide which one. Maybe I'll wear this one to the party tonight and this one to school tomorrow.
Well, you won't be going to school tomorrow.
Great. How come?
You know, your checkup, Dr. Gutierrez wants to do some more tests.
Tests? Why?
Some of the blood work needs to be redone.
What for?
I think they messed up at the lab. You know how they are. Were you just gonna stand there? Are you gonna help me cook?
He's what I do.
Hey, why are you picking on that gorgeous grandson of mine, huh? Look, I can't talk right now, Mama, okay? Why don't you just go and enjoy your party?
Because you need to be here with you.
Tell me, what's going on, Mia?
Change in there, Anita, and make yourself comfortable. I'll be back in a few minutes to draw some blood.
You can put on your own nightgown, sweetheart. I'm sure they won't mind. These hospital things are so ugly.
I still don't see why I have to stay overnight.
It saves time. They can get started earlier.
How about I go to the cafeteria and get you a cheeseburger?
No, thanks.
It's no trouble. Really. Bet you they have shakes, too. Nice cheeseburger. Chocolate shake. Chocolate bubbles. How about it?
Abe, she already said no.
Neil. Maybe I should just wait outside.
Mom?
Yeah?
Everything's all right, isn't it?
Sure. Sure it is, sweetheart. Everything's just fine. It's time for your pill.
Pill?
Midnight.
You're not sticking any IV into me until somebody tells me what's going on.
The doctor is on duty with the patient.
I'm gonna call my mom.
Sure. Okay. Why don't I see if I can find the doctor? Hello?
Mom?
Anissa, why aren't you asleep?
Tell me the truth. The truth.
I'll get dressed and come in.
No, you're an hour away. I want to know now.
Oh, Mia. Dr. Gutierrez.
says you have leukemia. Leukemia? It's cancer. That's what Dad's mother died of.
It's nothing like that, Mia.
Mama, I'm scared.
I'm coming in. I'll be there real fast. I'm coming in.
Mr. and Mrs. Ayala? I'm Dr. Leslie.
It's bad, isn't it?
Please sit down. Your daughter has CML, chronic myelogenous leukemia. It's a kind of cancer of the blood cells. Common in adults, but rare in someone of her age.
But you can help her, can't you?
We can give her drugs to help control the white blood cells and keep her condition stable. But for any chance at a permanent recovery, she's going to need a bone marrow transplant. I've arranged for Anissa to see Dr. Foreman at the City of Hope. She'll be in good hands there.
Doctor, please be straight with me. If Anissa doesn't get this bone marrow transplant, how much time does she have?
1 to 3 years. Maybe 5.
Oh, God.
Okay. So tell us about this bone marrow transplant.
The bone marrow is the tissue inside the bones where your blood cells are made. Honey says marrow's gone crazy.
So they do a transplant. See, they replace bad marrow with healthy marrow.
How? How can they do that? They remove all the old marrow and all the cancerous cells with a lot of radiation and chemotherapy.
Then they take a small amount of bone marrow from a donor with the same marrow type. They give that to Anissa.
It's incredible.
Okay. So that's what we do. Anissa will have this bone marrow transplant and she'll be fine again.
Yeah, but who's going to be the donor?
You.
Me? Why me?
Because a sibling stands the best chance for a match. And that's you, kid. See, the doctor said that outside the family, the possibility of finding a match isn't good.
It's not dangerous, Aaron. Your backside might hurt for a few days, but that's about it.
Okay.
Aaron. You're gonna save your sister's life. God has blessed you to give you a chance like that, huh?
You'll be fine, baby.
I'm proud of you, son.
I guess I'll have to be nice to Aaron from now on.
That is a small price to pay.
Hi. How's my girl?
I'm good.
I thought you were coming by later.
I finished early. Can I talk to you for a minute?
Sure. See you in a second.
What? What's wrong?
Mary, the doctor just phoned.
What is it?
Aaron's marrow doesn't match.
What? It has to. It has to.
It doesn't.
Abe. Abe, what did we do wrong? Why is this happening to us?
I don't know.
No bubbles, see?
She doesn't like needles.
Who does?
But if you want to keep your condition stable when you go home, you have to inject the interferon every day. Now, there may be some side effects, some shivering or other side effects, but that'll go away in a while. You clean the area with alcohol, pinch the skin, and then insert the needle fast so it doesn't hurt. Pull back on the plunger, and if there's no blood, then inject.
Why didn't you come in to see me?
I figured you'd be home soon. I wanted so bad to be able to help.
No, it's okay.
I would have done anything. Anything.
No.
Sorry.
Anissa! Breakfast! Anissa! Where is she?
Let her sleep in a bit.
Make sure there's no air. Clean the skin. Pinch it. Do it fast.
Anissa and Aaron. Lovely names. You have no other children?
No, I had a vasectomy after Anissa was born.
Mm-hmm. Everyone's been tested? You, cousins, aunts?
Everyone.
Yeah. The next step is to look for an unrelated donor, which can be quite difficult, I'm afraid. Marotypes are very specific. There are tens of thousands of different combinations.
Well, how do we do it, Dr. Foreman? Where do we start looking?
You list Anissa with the National Marrow Donor Registry and the International Registries.
Okay, we'll do that.
You should also contact a group called Lifesavers in Covina. They have donors coming in all the time.
Okay. What are the odds of finding someone?
Well, right now, about 1 in 20,000.
Burgers.
Double.
Yeah.
Yes.
Let's take my car, you guys.
It's 2 blocks.
We
can walk.
Oh, yeah. Let's take the car.
Yeah.
There's nothing wrong with my legs.
Nobody said there was.
Hey, maybe we should just hang out here.
Yeah, we don't have to go anywhere.
Look, guys, I'm not hungry, okay? You go without me. I got stuff to do.
Are you sure?
Well, if that's what you want.
So,
okay.
Later.
Yeah.
I think I got it.
We got a letter this morning from England, the Anthony Nolan Research Center.
No matches?
No, but they'll keep Anissa on file.
What's for
supper.
Liver. I figured tonight would be a good night to make it. Where are you going out?
Who said I'm going out?
It's Friday. You always go out on Friday.
Well, I'm not going out tonight. I'll order a pizza.
Anissa, why don't you call up some of the girls? They can sleep over. We'll rent some videos. They have so
Look,
many...
Look, Mom, things are different now.
With your friends? Why?
Because I'm different.
Oh, Anissa. Having a sickness doesn't make you another person.
Yes, it does. The new Anissa gives herself an injection every day. She gets her blood count checked weekly. She's looking around for a stranger to donate marrow to her so that she won't die. I wouldn't want to be my friend. Why should they?
Anissa, you're not giving them a chance.
Hi, Mary Ayala?
Yes.
Hi, I'm Rudy Brudico.
Hi.
Nice to meet you. Let's go to my office. Watch out for the toys. I also run my pediatric practice out of here. Mary, this is my wife, Diana. She volunteers here a couple days a week.
And more often, if I can.
Hi. Hi, Diana.
Hi, Mary. It's nice to meet you. I'll see you later.
Okay, sweetie.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. Please, have a seat. So, what can we do for you?
Well, my husband and I heard about this place, and he would be here today, but one of his guys got the flu, and anyway, I just thought that maybe there was a chance that you could...
We could help you.
Yeah, yes. My daughter, Anissa, has leukemia.
When was she diagnosed?
In April. She's on interferon now.
Okay. Is it keeping the condition under control?
Well, her white blood cell count is back down to normal, but, I mean, that could change at any moment. Every checkup, I just hold my breath.
Tell you what. Why don't you bring in Anissa, and we'll see what we can do together.
Well, I don't know if I can get her to come in. She's been really down lately.
Well, it's no wonder. I mean, one minute she's a healthy teenager, next minute something's taken away all the control she has over her life.
Over all our lives, the whole family.
You can get the control back, Mary. You, Anissa, everyone.
How?
By taking charge of the illness, instead of letting it take charge of you.
Oh, I see. Well, that's very easy for you to say. Well, let me tell you something. You're a doctor with all your degrees and certificates. But what I have is a child with leukemia.
Mary, you met my wife, Diana, when you came in?
Yes.
I started Lifesavers when she was diagnosed with leukemia.
I'm sorry.
No, please. Don't apologize. We found a donor. A man we never met is responsible for Diana being cancer-free today. The same thing can happen to you, too.
You really think so?
Yes. We'll organize events. We'll get people to come out and be tested. But we're going to need Anissa working together with us, aggressively fighting to save her own life. That's the first step, getting her involved.
It's not going to be easy. I'll have to catch her on a good day.
Billy, come on down here. Surgeon's up.
Mia, you'll be late for school.
I'm not going today.
Do you have a temperature again?
No, I'm okay. I just don't feel like going to school. That's all.
A good breakfast. That's what you need to give you some energy.
Mama, listen to me. Please.
Okay. I'm listening.
I feel like... some kind of a puppet that's being jerked around and lied to.
Lied to?
Mama, I am not a kid anymore. When you know that there's something in your body just waiting to kill you, it makes you grow up real fast. So give me the respect that you would give another adult and let me choose what's best for me.
Okay. No more lies. What about school?
Home study. That's what Heather did when she had that back operation. There's only a couple of months of school left. I want to finish them at home.
Okay. I'll call the school.
Mary?
I dreamt that we were out somewhere beautiful, with the fresh air and blue skies and mountains. It was a picnic. And we were all there, the whole family. You, me, Aaron, and Anissa. And Anissa looked so good. Her eyes were sparkling and her cheeks were rosy, just like she used to be, you know?
I know.
There was no cancer. I could feel that in the dream. And we all went towards this blanket. And I bent down. And I picked up a baby. A beautiful baby with dark eyes. And then I woke up. It was the first time in a long time I felt peaceful inside.
Yeah. It was a wonderful day.
Abe. I know you're gonna think I'm crazy.
Try me.
Abe. Time is running out and they haven't found a donor. They may never find one. The doctor says that a sibling has a 1 in 4 chance of being a match. Abe, what if we tried to have a baby?
A baby? Us? How can we have a baby?
I know the vasectomy and everything, but, you know, they can fix that, reverse it. It's done. I've read about it.
That kind of thing doesn't work a lot of the time. It's been 15 years, Mary.
Oh, you're not even gonna try?
It's not just me. What about you?
Oh.
Okay. Let's say they fix me up okay again. But you... You're 42 years old.
Oh, I'm healthy. Women my age have babies all the time.
No, it's too much of a risk. Mary... Even if everything worked, who says a baby's gonna match? I mean, Aaron doesn't match. How do we know a new baby wouldn't match?
We don't know. But as long as there's a tiniest chance, we have to at least try.
You want another disappointment again, Mary? Something else to cry over?
No baby is ever a disappointment. Look, if I could have it by myself, I would, but I can't have a baby alone.
How do we know the baby would be healthy? How do we know that it would be here? In time.
I told you, we don't know. We didn't know 15 years ago when you had that vasectomy that maybe we should have had another baby, that maybe that baby would have been the match for Anissa.
Mary, you can't think that.
Yes, I can. You know, you keep telling me all these things that we don't know. Well, I'm going to tell you something that we do know. That if we don't find a bone marrow match for Anissa, she will die. We know that she will die. Hey, our little girl is going to die.
Okay.
doctor. I'll go have it done. Well, it's like this.
What is it with you two?
Mary, you do it.
Oh, thanks a lot. Okay, well, remember a few weeks ago when your dad was in bed?
Yeah, the flu, right?
Not exactly.
What's the matter?
There's nothing the matter. It's just that he had a vasectomy a long, long time ago.
Wow, how come you never told me that?
You were 2 and a half at the time. We didn't think you would be interested.
Anyway, the doctor is...
I just had my plumbing put back to normal.
Why?
Yeah, why?
Well, because we...
Because we want to try and have a baby.
A baby?
You two are kind of old for that, aren't you?
Aaron, your father and I are in the prime of our life. Thank you very much. Right, Abe?
Right.
Okay, I'm sorry I said anything. But why are you going to try to have a baby?
Yeah, with me being sick and everything, maybe this isn't the best time.
Mija, this is the very best time in the world.
Oh, I see.
Adam, what's going on?
They want to have a baby so that if I die, they'll have a replacement.
Oh, Anissa, how can you say something like that?
It's true, isn't it?
No. We want to have a baby to try for a match for you. A marrow match.
You mean...
Well, there's a chance.
And no matter what happens, we're going to love this baby for itself.
Good. Maybe the new one won't let her down.
Aaron, you didn't let me down. It's not like you can help it.
I guess so.
Well, that's what we've been doing. Besides searching every corner of the earth for a donor. And now I think it's time that you did something for yourself.
What?
Hi. Hi, Mary.
Hi.
Hi, you must be Anissa. I'm Rudy Brudico. Nice to meet you.
I just came to look around.
Sure. This way. Straight ahead.
So this is our blue room. This is where all our volunteers work. Ben, how about you one of your grand tours?
Hi. Hi, Danny.
Oh, hi.
Danny Wilson, Anissa Ayala. Danny knows everything there is to know about this place.
Come on. We can begin with the important stuff, like which candy machine works. So these computers are where they store all the results from the blood tests and stuff. Once in a while, I sneak in and play Tetris.
So how come you know so much about this place? Is your mom a volunteer?
Well, when she's not working. I come down here on my own, mainly. Almost every night after school. Unless I have to go to the hospital for my treatment.
You have it too?
Yeah. Come on, I'll show you some more stuff.
That kid, Danny, he's really something. I mean, if he could be the way he is, I guess I should... I told him that I might come back one day next week, after school.
Did I hear something about school?
Yeah, but don't make a big deal out of it, okay?
Me? Why would I do that?
I'll get it for you.
What is it?
Dr. Foreman. He wants to talk to you. Hello, doctor.
I see. We'll be there first thing in the morning. Thank you for calling.
The truth, remember? Always the truth.
Your test Wednesday. Your white blood cell count is up.
Way up?
Way up.
We'll increase the dosage of the interferon. That should bring the white blood cell count back down to normal for the time being.
That's it? I was so scared.
You might start experiencing more side effects.
Well, she had that before, the shivering and the fever.
It was awful.
I know, Nisa. But interferon is an extremely potent drug, and you're taking a large dosage. I wish I could make the side effects disappear. But I can't. Just hang in there.
Call me tonight, I'm gonna die. I swear to God, I'll die.
Anissa! You're back.
Yeah, here I am.
I feel like a real jerk.
It's okay. You guys can talk about regular stuff in front of me. I'm still interested in guys.
You know, it's really great you're back and everything. I got a class.
Me too.
I'll see ya.
Don't they know it's not contagious?
Give them a chance, Anissa.
They're scared.
Of me? No. What's happened to you? If this thing could happen to you, it could happen to any of us.
You guys are supposed to be my friends.
We are. Really?
Yeah, right.
Hi, guys.
How you doing?
Hey. Hi. So, Anissa, we organized a rally and a test drive at your high school. I thought maybe you could say a few words to the kids.
No way. I'm not good at making speeches.
Oh, no, no. This is not a speech. You just tell them what's happening. Right, Danny?
Right. The first time I got up in front of people, it was at church. I was sweating. I felt sick. But then when I started to talk, it was like they really wanted me to do good. I mean, I could feel love coming right at me. Does that sound dumb?
No. But church is different. At school, the kids don't care about any of this stuff. They're all into their own thing, you know? They don't understand.
Really help if you spoke to them, Anissa?
I could go with you.
Why don't you do the speech?
It's your school.
You know, I gotta tell you, you never know. Because of what you say, somebody in the audience could volunteer to be tested. They could turn out to be a match for Danny.
I'd do the same for you. For sure.
Okay. Okay. I'll do it.
Great.
I'm telling you, it's a waste of time. Nobody's going to show up. They're not interested. All they care about is cars and boys and... Wow. Look at them.
It's okay.
Here. Take this.
What is it?
It's my lucky stone. Right, Mom?
That's right. He found it on the beach when he was a baby. He's had it ever since.
See how it feels real smooth and warm when you hold it? It makes you feel real good by just touching it. It's magic.
Magic, huh? I could use a little of that.
Come on, folks. Let's go. Students of Walnut High, your classmate, Anissa Ayala.
Thank you. It's hard for me to get up here and ask my friends for help. I don't know what plans you guys have for the future. But me? I always wanted to ride one of those gondolas in Venice. I've never done that. I've always wanted to go scuba diving. I've never done that. I'd like to learn to speak French. I haven't done that. And one day, I'd like to meet a really nice guy and get married and walk down the aisle in my dad's arm and watch my mom get all teary-eyed. Those are the things in the future for me. But unless somebody out there, maybe one of you, unless somebody out there donates the marrow that's going to save my life, then I have no future. And maybe it won't be a match for me, but you'll be a match for somebody else, like my friend Danny. Or the thousands of other people who are trying to beat this awful disease, who need your help. And we will beat it. We will. I will.
Well, I'll have to get 10 copies. I mean, one for Mama, one for Leonard, one for Vicky.
We'll frame one for the office.
Yeah. A&M Precision. Oh. Okay, I'll tell her. Is there anything that we can do? Okay. That was Rita Wilson, Danny's mother. He's in the hospital. She just wanted me to let Anissa know. It's funny how you can fool yourself. But it's always there.
I should have never given you my magic stone. Big mistake.
There. Now you'll be out of here in no time.
Yeah. The doctor said I should be out in a week or so.
See?
Anissa?
What?
Nothing.
Come on.
Well, if I were maybe 4 or 5 years older, would you go to a show with me or something?
Sure. Sure I would.
You got good taste, girl.
Extension 321. Thanks for waiting with me. It's kind of lonely sometimes.
Where's your husband?
No such beast. He left for greener pastures when Danny was little.
No other family?
Plenty of family, but they're all back east.
That's gotta be tough on you.
Yeah, but I got my boy. He's a fighter. He's gonna make it. All he needs is a donor. That's what I pray for. Every morning, every night. Yeah, I think I'm being hurt. How do you handle it?
I keep real busy. Abe and I had these brochures made up about Anissa, and when they're done, I'm gonna go around to a lot of places and make speeches and let people know how easy it is to be a donor.
Sounds good.
Yeah. And I'm gonna try and have a baby.
Maybe we'll both be hurt.
Yeah. I don't know what your father's up to. He was being very mysterious on the phone. But he said that we should eat with Adam, that he had some important business.
Get out, get red skirts!
Ha ha, da-da! The old man's finally flipped his cookie.
Tickets come. 4 tickets. To Hawaii!
Hawaii! We're going to Hawaii?
Tomorrow!
Oh, my God! Oh, my God! Can't believe it! Oh, Daddy! Oh, Daddy, thank you! Thank you so much!
Abe?
Yeah?
Never done anything like this before.
Well, maybe in my old age, I'm becoming a wild and crazy guy, huh?
You're trying to give her a good time, aren't you? I mean, in case...
I just figured, why not?
Yeah. Why not?
I gotta get my shaving kit.
Come on, we gotta catch a plane.
Come on.
Hi!
Mrs. Wilson.
Traffic was miserable. I thought I was gonna miss you.
Oh, Rita, you didn't have to come all the way out here.
Yes, I did. Excuse us, folks. I had to give you a going away gift from me and Danny, but you gotta promise not to open it until tonight. Promise?
I promise. Thank you.
You're welcome. I gotta get back to Danny. You have a wonderful time.
I will.
Okay. Bye.
Bye.
This is great. Aaron says he's going surfing tomorrow.
I know. I'm trying to talk Anissa into taking some hula lessons. God. No way.
Boy, all that flying. I'm zonked.
Want a bacon apple pie?
Mm. 25 years. After 25 years, you do that to me.
I try.
Drinks with little umbrellas.
Staff is on strike. Aaron, take these upstairs, huh?
Oh, now?
No, next Christmas. Oh.
What's the matter?
There was a message on the machine from Danny's mom. He died last Thursday.
Some of you men know Abe Ayala. Maybe you even served with him in Nam in 66 and 67. Anyhow, he has something he wants to say, so listen up. Abe?
Here. I've been sitting here thinking that a lot of you guys were heroes in Nam. But when you came back home, nobody knew. Nobody cared. Well, now's your chance to be a hero again. My daughter, Anissa, she's got leukemia. We need to find somebody with a bone marrow that matches hers. And in my book, whoever gives my little girl back her life is going to be a real hero. There's going to be blood testing next Monday at the Covina Mall. So if any of you guys would like to sign up.
Test.
A what?
Pregnancy test. If it turns blue, it's a positive result.
Oh my God. It turned blue! It turned blue! We're pregnant! Something.
Okay. Shoot.
Well,
I've been reading up on bone marrow transplants.
Yes?
Yeah, well, after all the chemo and radiation and stuff, I figure that kind of fries your insides.
Well, I've never heard it put quite like that before, but...
What I'm trying to say is, I always figured that one day I'd have kids, you know? Like my mom. I really love kids.
I'm sorry, Anissa. See, the massive doses of radiation...
I don't want to hear the details. So I'll never be able to have kids, huh?
You can always adopt.
It's not the same.
Anissa, listen to me. Every baby is a miracle. But right now, we have one enormous challenge ahead of us, and that's getting you well. Now, the only future that I want you to think about is yours, not your children's, not your grandchildren's, yours. Got it?
Come on, how many presents
are
you?
Not
going to tell, are they?
Oh, Anissa, ever since you were a little girl, you keep on.
Well, I'm so glad you came.
No, I didn't want to, believe me. Then suddenly I heard Danny's voice saying, get off your butt, Ma, it's Christmas. I always loved Christmas. So, how you doing?
Oh, I'm okay. Doctor wants me to have an amniocentesis.
Well, when you're over 35, that's what they do.
I know. Abe's against it. He says that we're going to have this child no matter what, so why go through all the fancy tests?
Well, what about you?
I think I should have the amnio. You know, I've been reading a lot of stuff, and these days, if there's a problem with the baby, sometimes they can even help before it's born. I think I have to give my child that chance, don't you?
Of course you do.
I know I'm right.
So why the long face?
Rita, I don't think I could stand any more bad news.
Come on, you two. They're putting the star on the tree.
You go ahead, Rita. I'll be there in a sec.
Okay.
That sounds good. No, Aaron will be away for the weekend with his buddies, but Anissa will come. Yeah. Okay. See you then. Bye-bye.
Where am I going?
The Espinosas. They're having a barbecue.
Mom, do we know anybody there that I can...
Hello? What? I'm sorry. Oh, Aaron, the volume, please.
Okay.
Thank you. I'm sorry, who is this? Dr. Grady, hi. Yes. Oh, thank you. Thank you. The amnio results. She's a girl. And she's just fine.
Oh, my sister.
Do they know if she's a match?
Well, no, they have to do some more testing. They won't know that for a while.
But she's all right. That's what's important. What are we going to call her?
Marisa.
I like it.
Mary and Anissa. Marisa.
Part you, part me.
Come on, kiddo. Try and look pleasant. You can have a good time.
I'm only doing this for you.
Fine. Then smile for me. Fernando, Glenda, we made it.
You smile bigger than that.
Yes.
Yeah, I know that.
Where's Anissa?
She's over there.
Hi.
Hi.
Listen, you don't by any chance know how to make salad dressing, do you?
Sure.
Yeah? Great, because I'm in charge of the salad. And I told my folks I had everything under control. Forgot to buy the dressing.
Very irresponsible.
Hey, I was hoping you'd be on my side. Ooh. Brian Espinosa.
Anissa Ayala.
Oh. Nice to meet you, Anissa.
You thought I'd be bald and shriveled up?
No. It was just that the last time I met you, I think you were 13 years old and had thick steel braces in your mouth. It must have worked. You turned out beautiful.
Thank you.
But I'll buy them at a discount store. I'm
Aaron,
with new tires.
I can. It'll still be a piece of junk with new tires.
Anissa, you can eat anything?
I'm not hungry. Do you think he liked me?
Everybody likes you.
He's 23. I'm not even through 11th grade yet. He's probably got lots of older, sophisticated girlfriends.
Please, I'm eating.
Aaron, butt out.
What did I say?
Brian? Yeah, I remember you. The barbecue, wasn't it? Mm-hmm. Oh, well, let me see. Yeah, I think I can do that. Yeah, it sounds like fun. Okay, so I'll see you at noon. Bye.
I'll never know why you make me feel this way. When you by my side, I'll love you every day. Because of you, lady, my love won't pass away. Don't know how to tell you, girl, that my love is here to stay.
Mary.
What?
It's 2 in the morning. They just came in.
Who?
Anissa and Brian. Let's go downstairs.
Abe, wait.
For what? Anissa's just a kid.
Abe, we were just kids, you and me.
That was different. We were getting married.
Abe. Anissa may never have the chance to get married.
Don't say that.
What if time runs out for her like it did for Danny?
It can't.
Precision. Yes, it is.
Let me see the sheet there.
Oh, hold on a sec. Abe, it's a reporter from the Los Angeles Chronicle. She saw the story in the Tribune and she wants to do a piece on us.
It'll be good publicity for the blood drive next week.
Hello, Miss Carter. Why don't you come by this afternoon? The Ayala case focuses on the question of the parents' ability to do what is in the best interest of the baby when their decisions are being influenced by the imminent life or death of an existing child.
How much potential? risk and suffering can parents demand of one child for the benefit of another child? What the hell is all this about?
We talked about what little risks there would be.
Well, what right have they got?
Look, Abe, it's probably gonna blow over. It's just a newspaper article.
All I'm saying is that we're doing everything we can in order to save our daughter. And no parent's gonna just stand by and wait for their child to die and do nothing. That's all I'm saying. No comment, huh?
Abe, this is crazy. I can't believe the questions that they're asking. We have to do something.
What? What can we do? Tell me.
I feel that my baby is a gift from God.
She's our miracle, and people have no right to say that what my parents are doing is bad.
From the medical aspect, it's a point of fact that donating marrow is completely safe, even for a baby.
Everyone's jumping the gun about the transplant anyway. We don't even know yet if our baby will be a match for Anissa.
But whether she is or she isn't, we couldn't love her or want her any more than we already do. All of us, our whole family. That's all we have to say.
Thank you for coming, ladies and gentlemen. No more questions.
The child was conceived so that she could serve as a bone marrow donor for her sister, who is dying of leukemia. But the concept of having a baby for the purpose of a transplant has many ethicists and lawyers concerned.
If you ask me, it's an absolutely terrifying thought that we are growing human beings in order to harvest organs.
My primary argument with this whole scenario is that we are seeing humans used as spare parts. Well, in my view, this is a slight tinge of cannibalism about it.
It does seem to me that we are on a
turn it off. I can't watch this. How can he say that?
I don't know.
Hey, what are you guys doing home so early? Is everything okay?
Went to the mall.
And everybody kept coming up to me and asking me stuff about the baby. I just can't handle it, Mom.
Ignore it, mija. They're just curious. I'll get it. Hello? Yes, it is. I see. Okay. Yes. Yes, thank you for calling. Abe? Abe, would you come in here, please? Anissa, Brian?
It's not a mom. What's wrong?
It's a baby. My Anissa, they just got back the rest of the test results. She's a match. She's a perfect match.
I feel like she's mine. Like she's my little girl.
I have something for you.
A graduation present?
No. Well, you gonna look inside?
I need some time to think.
What's to think about?
What? Okay? It's okay?
It's my leg a cramp. It's from the interferon.
Oh, it's okay. It's okay. It'll be better soon. It'll be fine.
So, what now? I think it's time to do the transplant.
Because of the side effects of the interferon?
No. Because I've looked at your latest test results, and I don't think we can wait any longer, Anissa.
The baby. She'll be okay?
I've spoken to Dr. Britico. He says Marissa's ready. She'll be just fine.
Then I'm ready too.
Yeah.
Well, what happens now?
Once Anissa checks into the hospital, the next 12 days are going to be like a countdown towards the transplant. She'll receive massive doses of radiation and chemotherapy to kill all the diseased marrow, so she'll be prepared for the transplant. Unfortunately, this process also destroys the immune system. We'll take good care of her. Now, on the 12th day, Marissa will be brought into another section of the hospital. We'll extract the healthy marrow from her.
She won't feel anything.
She'll be asleep. The whole thing will be over for her in 20 minutes. There'll be no stitches and no cutting. Just a band-aid or two on her hip when she wakes up.
She's so tiny.
Anissa, I want you to understand that I couldn't have continued on this case with a clear conscience if I thought that the baby would be used, that she wouldn't be cared for or loved for who she was, rather than for what she might be providing. Okay?
Okay. Oh, look, you have a nice view of the garden.
Will I have to wear a mask like that?
For about 3 months after the transplant, except when you're alone. What's in there?
You know, clothes, shoes, stuff. I mean, I'm gonna be here for a while.
I'm afraid this is all you're gonna need.
It, isn't it?
What do you mean, baby?
We can't turn back now. They've killed everything inside me. If the transplant doesn't work...
It'll work. We've come this far, Mia. God won't let us down now.
Mama, just in case. I want to tell you that I love you and Daddy so very, very much. My life has been great. And Marissa, she's a little part of me.
Yes.
So if I die, when you see her,
your baby from the transplant?
I don't know. Just leave us alone.
How many hours will the operation on little Marissa take?
20 minutes. She'll be fine.
Any second thoughts about the ethical implications of the operation?
What is the percentage of freedom?
How does it feel knowing both of your daughters
no.
Lives are in jeopardy?
Holy
God.
What is the
Because the press are there, Dr. Foreman arranged for us to use a side entrance.
Down and try to relax, okay? Look, you just take it from somebody who's been through this before. My own wife.
We're relaxed.
Yeah, get you too.
We've extracted the mirror. Marissa's doing fine. just so you know exactly what's happening now. The mirror is being taken to Anissa. Drip through the IV into a catheter in her chest. No matter how often I see this, I never fail to marvel at the sheer wonder of it. I mean, of one person being given new life by another person. Anissa will remain in isolation for about 3 weeks, during which time, if everything works as we hope it will, her body will direct Marissa's healthy stem cells to all the right spots. Where they'll make new blood cells.
You're right up in those, aren't you? Did you ever think you might lose Anissa? Has her illness affected your relationship in any way? Please, can you speak to us?
Do you have anything better to do? Welcome home, baby. You know, Grandma's coming in a little while. She's bringing Marissa.
We scrubbed your room.
All those stuffed animals, God knows what terms they have.
I rented you some great videos.
You want something to eat?
No, thanks. I want to talk to Brian. Alone.
Sure. We've got plenty to do upstairs.
Yeah.
Some water, honey? Juice?
No, thanks.
What's the matter, Anissa?
I don't know. In the hospital, I had a lot of time to think.
And?
Well, I don't know what's gonna happen to me. I don't know what's ahead.
Who does? Anyway, look, I don't need to see into the future. I know about now. I love you. I always will.
That's just what I'm talking about. There might not be an always. I think that we should stop seeing each other.
I think you're a little tired.
I am more than tired. I am scared. Look at me. I don't even know if this is gonna work.
It's going to work.
Brian, I want you to go. It's for your own good.
I know what's good for me. You are. Anissa. Anissa. I love you. If you need me, I'm here.
Door.
When we're married, I'm going to insist that you carry me across the threshold.
How about a drive in the morning? The weather is so gorgeous.
No, thanks.
Hello? Brian, hi. I'm fine. Yeah, hold on. It's Brian for you. Anissa, he's been calling for weeks.
Tell him I'm too tired to talk, okay?
Brian, she's a little tired now. Okay, bye-bye.
Hi.
Hi. The meeting ran late tonight.
Yeah, guys were taking a vote. They decided to elect a queen for the Vietnam Vets reunion next week.
Oh.
First time ever. And guess who the queen is? Miss Anissa Ayala.
Hey, that's great.
They're gonna crown you on Sunday.
Tell them to choose somebody else, Dad.
They don't want somebody else. They want you.
I'm not going.
Anissa. Anissa, you can't stay in the house forever. You've got to get out. You've got to see people. Start up your life again.
No, I am not going. Say thank you to the guys, Dad, but tell them I can't make it.
Hi.
Hi. I thought you were going to the reunion.
We are. I just wanted to give you this before we went.
The stone. Danny's magic stone. Where did you get it?
Danny's mother gave it to me after he died. She said he wanted you to have it. I've just been waiting for the right time to give it to you.
And this is it?
Yeah. Do you know why those guys chose you as queen? Because you're someone who's been through a war. Like them.
Yeah, look at me.
Oh, Mia. Sometimes the hardest part of the war is after. That's when you have to fight the hardest not to give up. The magic in Danny's stone, it comes from inside of you. It comes from hope and faith and love. You can use it if you want. I have to go. I love you. We all love you.
My dad said Anissa was going to be here.
Yeah, she wasn't up to it.
Huh? Well,
it's good.
Whatever.
Good to see you.
Thanks.
Abe. Nice to see you,
Abe. Better get up there, I guess, huh?
Can I have everyone's attention for a moment, please? Abe Ayala would like to say a few words.
Abe. Hi, guys. It's a real honor for my family and me that you elected our daughter Anissa as the first queen for the Vietnam Veterans of America reunion. It turns out that she's a little late, but she made it. She made it. Beautiful, sweetheart.
I'd like to say thank you for giving me this award. It really means a lot to me. Thank you for all the good thoughts, all the prayers, all the support. Without you, I don't think I would be here today. 'Cause when it really comes down to it, we're all pretty tiny and helpless in a world that can be cruel and unfair. But what makes us strong, what can give us the strength of giants, is love. I'm very lucky to be loved the way that I am. So thank you very much. And please keep your prayers with us.
No bubbles, see?
She doesn't like needles.
Who does? But if you want to keep your condition stable when you go home, you have to inject the interferon every day. Now, there may be some side effects, some shivering or other side effects, but that'll go away in a while. You clean the area with alcohol, pinch the skin, and then insert the needle. Fast, so it doesn't hurt. Pull back on the plunger, and if there's no blood, then inject.
Hi. Why didn't you come in to see me?
I figured you'd be home soon. I wanted so bad to be able to help.
It's okay.
I would have done anything. Anything.
Let her sleep in a bit.
I'm tired of milligrams. Make sure there's no air. Do you have a skin? Pinch it. Do it fast.
Why didn't you wait for me?
Because I wanted to do it alone.
Oh, baby, you don't ever have to do anything alone. You understand? That's why I'm here. That's why I'm here.
Anissa and Aaron. Lovely names. You have no other children?
No, I had a vasectomy after Anissa was born.
Mm-hmm. Everyone's been tested? You, cousins, aunts?
Everyone.
Yeah. The next step is to look for an unrelated donor, which can be quite difficult, I'm afraid. Marotypes are very specific. There are tens of thousands of different combinations.
Well, how do we do it, Dr. Foreman? Where do we start looking?
You list Anissa with the National Marrow Donor Registry and the International Registries.
Okay, we'll do that.
You should also contact a group called Lifesavers in Covina. They have donors coming in all the time.
Okay. What are the odds of finding someone?
Well, right now, about 1 in 20,000.
I'm out of here. Burgers. Double.
Yeah. Yes.
Let's take my car, you guys.
It's two blocks. I can walk.
Oh, yeah. Let's take the car.
Yeah. There's nothing wrong with my legs.
Nobody said there was. Hey, maybe we should just hang out here.
Yeah, we don't have to go anywhere.
Look, guys. I'm not hungry, okay? You go without me. I got stuff to do.
Are you sure?
Well, if that's what you want.
So,
okay.
Later.
Yeah.
Are you still in Carson's class?
There. All right, give me a hand, will you?
I think I got it.
We got a letter this morning from England. The Anthony Nolan Research Center.
No matches.
No, but they'll keep Anissa on file.
What's for supper?
Liver. I figured tonight would be a good night to make it. Where are you going out?
Who said I'm going out?
It's Friday. You always go out on Friday.
Well, I'm not going out tonight. I'll order a pizza.
Anissa. Why don't you call up some of the girls? They can sleep over. We'll rent some videos. They have so
Look,
many...
Look, Mom, things are different now.
With your friends? Why?
Because I'm different.
Oh, Anissa. Having a sickness doesn't make you another person.
Yes, it does. The new Anissa gives herself an injection every day. She gets her blood count checked weekly. She's looking around for a stranger to donate marrow to her so that she won't die. I wouldn't want to be my friend. Why should they?
Anissa, you're not giving them a chance.
Come on. Let her work it out by herself.
Hi, Mary Ayala?
Yes.
Hi, I'm Rudy Brudico.
Hi.
Nice to meet you. Let's go to my office, sir. Watch out for the toys. I also run my pediatric practice out of here. Mary, this is my wife, Diana. She volunteers here a couple days a week.
And more often if I can.
Hi. Hi, Diana.
Hi, Mary. It's nice to meet you. I'll see you later.
Okay, sweetie.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. Please, have a seat. So...
Well, my husband and I heard about this place, and he would be here today, but one of his guys got the flu, and anyway, I just thought that maybe there was a chance that you could...
We could help you.
Yeah, yes. My daughter, Anissa, has leukemia.
When was she diagnosed?
in April. She's on interferon now.
Okay. Is it keeping the condition under control?
Well, her white blood cell count is back down to normal, but, I mean, that could change at any moment. Every checkup, I just hold my breath.
Tell you what. Why don't you bring in Anissa? And we'll see what we can do together.
Well, I don't know if I can get her to come in. She's been really down lately.
Well, it's no wonder. I mean, one minute she's a healthy teenager. Next minute, something's taken away all the control she has over her life.
Over all our lives, the whole family.
You can get the control back, Mary. You, Anissa, everyone.
How?
By taking charge of the illness instead of letting it take charge of you.
Oh, I see. Well, that's very easy for you to say. Well, let me tell you something. You're a doctor with all your degrees and certificates. But what I have is a child with leukemia.
Mary, you met my wife, Diana, when you came in?
Yes.
I started Lifesavers when she was diagnosed with leukemia.
I'm sorry.
No, please. Don't apologize. We found a donor. A man we'd never met is responsible for Diana being cancer-free today. The same thing can happen to you, too.
You really think so?
Yes. We'll organize events. We'll get people to come out and be tested. But we're going to need Anissa working together with us, aggressively fighting to save her own life. That's the first step, getting her involved.
It's not going to be easy. I'll have to catch her on a good day.
Billy, come on down here. Sergeant's up.
Mija, you'll be late for school.
I'm not going today.
Do you have a temperature again?
No, I'm okay. I just don't feel like going to school. That's all.
A good breakfast. That's what you need to give you some energy.
Mama, listen to me. Please.
Okay. I'm listening.
I feel like some kind of a puppet that's being jerked around and lied to.
Lied to?
Mama, I am not a kid anymore. When you know that there's something in your body just waiting to kill you, it makes you grow up real fast. So give me the respect that you would give another adult and let me choose what's best for me.
Okay. No more lies. What about school?
Home study. That's what Heather did when she had that back operation. There's only a couple of months of school left. I want to finish them at home.
Okay. I'll call the school.
Mary?
I dreamt that we were out somewhere beautiful, with the fresh air and blue skies and mountains. And it was a picnic. And we were all there, the whole family. You, me, Aaron, and Anissa. And Anissa looked so good. Her eyes were sparkling and her cheeks were rosy, just like she used to be, you know?
I know.
There was no cancer. I could feel that in the dream. And we all went towards this blanket. And I bent down. And I picked up a baby. A beautiful baby with dark eyes. first time in a long time I felt peaceful inside.
Yeah. It was a wonderful dream.
Abe. I know you're gonna think I'm crazy.
Try me.
Abe. Time is running out and they haven't found a donor. They may never find one. The doctor says that a sibling has a 1 in 4 chance of being a match. Abe, what if we tried to have a baby?
A baby? Us? How can we have a baby?
I know the vasectomy and everything, but, you know, they can fix that, reverse it, isn't done. I've read about it.
That kind of thing doesn't work a lot of the time. It's been 15 years, Mary.
Oh, you're not even gonna try?
It's not just me. What about you?
Oh.
Okay. Let's say they fix me up okay again. But you... You're 42 years old.
Oh, I'm healthy. Women my age have babies all the time.
No, it's too much of a risk. Mary... Even if everything worked, who says a baby's gonna match? Huh? I mean, Aaron doesn't match. How do we know a new baby wouldn't match?
We don't know. But as long as there's the tiniest chance, we have to at least try.
You want another disappointment again, Mary? Something else to cry over?
No baby is ever a disappointment. Look, if I could have it by myself, I would, but I can't have a baby alone.
How do we know the baby would be healthy? How do we know that it would be here? In time.
I told you, we don't know. We didn't know 15 years ago when you had that vasectomy that maybe we should have had another baby, that maybe that baby would have been the match for Anissa.
Mary, you can't think that way.
Yes, I can. You know, you keep telling me all these things that we don't know. Well, I'm going to tell you something that we do know. That if we don't find a bone marrow match for Anissa, she will die. We know that she will die. Hey, our little girl is going to die.
Okay. You find a doctor. I'll go have it done. Kids, Well, it's like this.
What is it with you two?
Are you... Tickets come. 4 tickets. To Hawaii.
Hawaii? We're going to Hawaii?
Tomorrow.
Oh, my God. Oh, my God. Oh, my God. I can't believe it. Oh, Daddy.
Oh, Dad.
Oh, Daddy, thank you. Thank you so much.
Abe?
Yeah?
Never done anything like this before.
Well, maybe in my old age, I'm becoming a wild and crazy guy, huh?
You're trying to give her a good time, aren't you? I mean, in case...
I just figured, why not?
Yeah. Why not?
I gotta get my shaving kit.
Miserable. I've had to ask admission.
Oh, Rita, you didn't have to come all the way out here.
Yes, I did. Excuse us, folks. I had to give you a going-away gift from me and Danny, but you got to promise not to open it until tonight. Promise?
I promise. Thank you.
You're welcome. I gotta get back to Danny. You have a wonderful time.
I will.
Okay. Bye.
This is great. Aaron says he's going surfing tomorrow.
I know. I'm trying to talk Anissa into taking some hula lessons. Oh, my God. No way.
Boy, all that flying. I'm zonked.
Want a bacon apple pie?
25 years. After 25 years, you do that to me.
I try.
Umbrellas. Staff is on strike. Aaron, take these upstairs, huh?
Oh, now?
No, next Christmas.
What's the matter?
There was a message on the machine from Danny's mom. He died last Thursday.
Something he wants to say, so listen up. Abe?
Here. I've been sitting here thinking that a lot of you guys were heroes in NAMM. But when you came back home, nobody knew. Nobody cared. And now's your chance to be a hero again. My daughter, Anissa, she's got leukemia. We need to find somebody with a bone marrow that matches hers. And in my book, whoever gives my little girl back her life is going to be a real hero. There's going to be blood testing next Monday at the Covina Mall. So if any of you guys would like to sign up,
come here, sit.
here.
Have you seen my new blouse?
No.
What's that?
A pregnancy test.
A what?
Pregnancy test. If it turns blue, it's a positive result.
Oh, my God. Can I talk to you for a minute?
Sure. Let's go to the office. Okay. Grab a seat. So what's up?
I'd like to ask you about something.
Okay. Shoot.
Well, I've been reading up on bone marrow transplants.
Yes.
Yeah, well, after all the chemo and radiation and stuff, I figure that kind of fries your insides.
Well, I've never heard it put quite like that before, but...
What I'm trying to say is, I always figured that one day I'd have kids, you know? Like my mom. I really love kids.
I'm sorry, Anissa. See, the massive doses of radiation...
I don't want to hear the details. So I'll never be able to have kids, huh?
You can, always adopt.
It's not the same.
Anissa, listen to me. Every baby is a miracle. But right now, we have one enormous challenge ahead of us, and that's getting you well. Now, the only future that I want you to think about is yours, not your children's, not your grandchildren's, yours. Got it?
I didn't do it.
Come on, how many presents did I get?
I'm not going to tell.
What are they?
Oh, Anissa, ever since you were a little girl, you keep on
walking. Rita, I'm so glad you came.
No, I didn't want to, believe me. Then suddenly I heard Danny's voice saying, get off your butt, Ma, it's Christmas. You always loved Christmas. So... how you doing?
Oh, I'm okay. Doctor wants me to have an amniocentesis.
Well, when you're over 35, that's what they do.
I know. Abe's against it. He says that we're gonna have this child no matter what, so why go through all the fancy tests?
Well, what about you?
I think I should have the amnio. You know, I've been reading a lot of stuff, and these days, if there's a problem with the baby, sometimes they can even help before it's born. I think I have to give my child that chance, don't you?
Of course you do.
I know I'm right.
So why the long face?
Rita, I don't think I could stand any more bad news.
Come on, you two. They're putting the star on the tree.
You go ahead, Rita. I'll be there in a sec.
Okay.
Sunday? Sure, that sounds good. No, Aaron will be away for the weekend with his buddies, but Anissa will come. Yeah. Okay. See you then. Bye-bye.
Where am I going?
The Espinosas. They're having a barbecue.
Mom, there'll be nobody there that I can...
Hello? What? I'm sorry. Oh, Aaron, the volume, please.
Okay.
Thank you. I'm sorry, who is this? Dr. Grady, hi. Yes. Oh, thank you. Thank you. The amnio results. She's a girl. And she's just fine.
Oh, my sister.
Do they know if she's a match?
Well, no, they have to do some more testing. They won't know that for a while.
But she's all right. That's what's important. What are we going to call her?
Marisa.
I like it.
Mary and Anissa. Marisa.
Part you, part me.
Come on, kiddo. Try and look pleasant. You can have a good time.
I'm only doing this for you.
Fine. And smile for me. Fernando, Glenda, we made it.
You can smile bigger than that.
Yes?
Yeah, I know that.
Where's Anissa?
She's over there.
Hi.
Hi.
Listen, you don't by any chance know how to make salad dressing, do you?
Sure.
Yeah? Great, because I'm in charge of the salad. And I told my folks I had everything under control. Forgot to buy the dressing.
Very irresponsible.
Hey, I was hoping you'd be on my side. Who? Brian Espinosa.
Anissa Ayala.
Oh. Nice to meet you, Anissa.
You thought I'd be bald and shriveled up?
No. It was just that the last time I met you, I think you were 13 years old and had thick steel braces in your mouth. It must have worked. You turned out beautiful.
Thank you.
But I'll buy them at a discount store.
Aaron,
with new tires,
I can... It'll still be a piece of junk with new tires.
Anissa, you need anything?
I'm not hungry. Do you think he liked me?
Everybody likes you.
He's 23. I'm not even through 11th grade yet. He's probably got lots of older, sophisticated girlfriends.
Please, I'm eating.
Aaron, butt out.
What did I say?
Brian? Yeah, I remember you. The barbecue, wasn't it? Mm-hmm. Oh, well, let me see. Yeah, I think I can do that. Yeah, it sounds like fun. Okay, so I'll see you at...
Hey, it's your birthday. You shouldn't be worrying about the party.
No,
Bye, hon. Look, Mama, I gotta run. I'll see you tonight, birthday girl.
Let's go.
Okay, in a sec. Anissa, do you want a ride?
No, Heather's picking me up. Have you seen my history notes?
In the family room on top of the TV.
Oh, what would I do without you?
It's me. See you later.
Hello? Hi, Dr. Gutierrez. She just left. Hold on a sec. I'll see if I can catch her.
Dr. Gutierrez is on the phone.
Oh, darn. I was supposed to call her back about the Women's League luncheon.
Mary, come on. Gotta...
Tell her I'll call her back when I get to work.
Okay. One, two, three, and four. Back, step.
So, are you on for the weekend or what?
Well, I haven't exactly asked my mom yet.
Anissa, everybody's going.
Yeah. I know. It's just that I have to wait until she's in a really good mood so she'll say yes.
It's not like we're going to the moon. I mean, it's only Long Beach.
Well, to my mom, that's the moon.
Hey, are you okay?
Yeah, sure. I guess I just overdid it.
Okay, come on. Let's get you changed. Okay, come on.
I'll get you some water.
No, no, I'm okay, really.
Let's go to the mall.
Oh, here it is. 1752. Okay, no problem. Bye, Tony.
Dr. Gutierrez is on the private line.
Oh, yeah, thanks.
Oh, it is.
Francis, hi.
Yeah, I'm sorry I didn't get back to you sooner. This morning has just been crazy. Anyway, I have all the info for the luncheon.
Oh. Well, what is it then?
I see.
Well, what's exactly the problem? All right, okay. We'll be there within the half hour. Okay. Okay? I don't know.
Abe.
What's up?
Abe, Frances Gutierrez just phoned.
Yeah?
She said the results from Anissa's checkup show some irregularity and she wants to see us right away.
What kind of irregularity?
I don't know. She didn't discuss it on the phone.
Okay, let's go.
She's just a child. 16 years old.
Mary, don't. They could have made a mistake. Couldn't they? I mean, all the time they make mistakes.
It's leukemia.
Is she gonna die?
Oh, some types of leukemia respond very well to treatment.
And other types?
No.
No.
Oh, Mary. Mary, please. Please, let's not jump to conclusions. We have to do a series of tests to determine exactly what type of leukemia we're dealing with. Okay? Okay.
Tell Miss Truck to be ready by tomorrow afternoon. You take care of things there. Everything's okay at the shop. Mary, let's call off the party.
Anissa would know that something is wrong. Just go and get the chips, okay? Anything.
Mary.
I'm okay. Just go and get the chips. I'm okay.
Hi, Mom.
Hi there. Where were you?
I only had one period after lunch, English, and we were just going to review stuff. So Heather, Jenny, Claudine, and me just took the afternoon off.
It's no big deal, Mom. I'm way ahead in English. We had lunch at the mall, and then we went shopping.
Sounds great. You want something to eat?
No lecture? What's going on?
Nothing. I just have a lot on my mind with everybody coming tonight. Do you want a sandwich?
I'm not hungry. Look what I've got. You like? They were both half price. I couldn't decide which one. Maybe I'll wear this one to the party tonight and this one to school tomorrow.
Well, you won't be going to school tomorrow.
Great. How come?
You know your checkup? Dr. Gutierrez wants to do some more tests.
Tests? Why?
Some of the blood work needs to be redone.
What for?
I think they messed up at the lab. You know how they are. Were you just going to stand there? You're going to help me cook.
He's what I do.
Hey, why are you picking on that gorgeous grandson of mine, huh? Look, I can't talk right now, Mama, okay? Why don't you just go and enjoy your party?
Because you need to be here with you.
Tell me, what's going on, Mia?
Change in there, Anissa, then make yourself comfortable. I'll be back in a few minutes to draw some blood.
You can put on your own nightgown, sweetheart. I'm sure they won't mind. These hospital things are so ugly.
I still don't see why I have to stay overnight.
It saves time. They can get started earlier.
How about I go to the cafeteria and get you a cheeseburger?
No, thanks.
It's no trouble. Really. Bet you they have shakes, too. Nice cheeseburger. Chocolate shake. Chocolate bubbles. How about it?
Abe, she already said no.
Yeah. Maybe I should just wait outside.
Mom?
Yeah?
Everything's all right, isn't it?
Sure. Sure it is, sweetheart. Everything's just fine. It's time for your pill.
Pill?
You'll be in around midnight.
You're not sticking any IV into me until somebody tells me what's going on.
The doctor is on duty with the patient.
I'm gonna call my mom.
Sure. Okay. Why don't I see if I can find the doctor? Hello?
Mom?
Anissa, why aren't you asleep?
Tell me the truth. The truth.
I'll get dressed and come in.
No, you're an hour away. I want to know now.
Oh, Mia. Dr. Gutierrez.
says you have leukemia.
Leukemia? It's cancer. That's what Dad's mother died of.
It's nothing like that, Mia.
Mama, I'm scared.
I'm coming in. I'll be there real fast. I'm coming in.
Thinking a lot about Vietnam. I never thought there was going to be anything that would make me feel that way again. Like the center just dropped out of the world.
Mr. and Mrs. Ayala? I'm Dr. Leslie.
It's bad, isn't it?
Please sit down. Your daughter has CML, chronic myelogenous leukemia. It's a kind of cancer of the blood cells, common in adults, but rare in someone of her age.
But you can help her, can't you?
We can give her drugs to help control the white blood cells and keep her condition stable. But for any chance at a permanent recovery, she's going to need a bone marrow transplant. I've arranged for Anissa to see Dr. Foreman at the City of Hope. She'll be in good hands there.
Doctor, please be straight with me. If Anissa doesn't get this bone marrow transplant, how much time does she have?
1 to 3 years. Maybe 5.
Oh, God.
Okay. So tell us about this bone marrow transplant.
The bone marrow is the tissue inside the bones where your blood cells are made. Anissa's marrow's gone crazy.
So they do a transplant. See, they replace bad marrow with healthy marrow.
How? How can they do that? They remove all the old marrow and all the cancerous cells with a lot of radiation and chemotherapy.
Then they take a small amount of bone marrow from a donor with the same marrow type. They give that to Anissa.
It's incredible.
Okay. So that's what we do. Anissa will have this bone marrow transplant, and she'll be fine again.
Yeah, but who's going to be the donor?
You.
Me? Why me?
Because a sibling stands the best chance for a match. And that's you, kid. See, the doctor said that outside the family, the possibility of finding a match isn't good.
It's not dangerous, Aaron. Her backside might hurt for a few days, but that's about it.
Okay.
Aaron, you're gonna save your sister's life. God has blessed you to give you a chance like that. Huh?
You'll be fine, baby.
I'm proud of you, son.
I guess I'll have to be nice to Aaron from now on.
That is a small price to pay.
Hi. How's my girl?
I'm good.
I thought you were coming by later.
Finished early. Can I talk to you for a minute?
Sure. See you in a second.
What? What's wrong?
Mary, the doctor just phoned.
What is it?
Aaron's marrow doesn't match.
What? It has to. It has to.
It doesn't.
Abe. Abe, what did we do wrong? Why is this happening to us?
I don't know. I don't know, sweetheart. I wish you knew. You do it.
Oh, thanks a lot. Okay, well, remember a few weeks ago when your dad was in bed?
Yeah, the flu, right?
Not exactly.
What's the matter?
There's nothing the matter. It's just that he...
Well, he had a vasectomy a long, long time ago.
Wow, how come you never told me that?
You were 2 and a half at the time. We didn't think you would be interested.
Anyway, the doctor is...
I just had my plumbing put back to normal.
Why?
Yeah, why?
Well, because we...
Because we want to try and have a baby.
A baby?
You two are kind of old for that, aren't you?
Aaron, your father and I are in the prime of our life. Thank you very much. Right, Abe?
Right.
Okay, I'm sorry I said anything. But why are you going to try to have a baby?
Yeah, with me being sick and everything, maybe this isn't the best time.
Mija, this is the very best time in the world.
Oh, I see.
Aaron, what's going on?
They want to have a baby so that if I die, they'll have a replacement.
Oh, Anissa. How can you say something like that?
It's true, isn't it?
No. We want to have a baby to try for a match for you. A marital match.
You mean...
Well, there's a chance.
And no matter what happens, we're going to love this baby for itself.
Good. Maybe the new one won't let her down.
Aaron, you didn't let me down. It's not like you can help it.
I guess so.
Well, that's what we've been doing. Besides searching every corner of the earth for a donor. And now I think it's time that you did something for yourself.
What?
Hi. Hi, Mary.
Hi.
Hi, you must be Anissa. I'm Rudy Brudico. Nice to meet you.
I just came to look around.
Sure. This way. Straight ahead.
So this is our blue room. This is where all our volunteers work. Ben, how about you want your grand tours?
Hi, Danny.
Hello. Hi.
Danny Wilson, Anissa Ayala. Danny knows everything there is to know about this place.
Come on. We can begin with the important stuff, like, which candy machine works. So these computers are where they store all the results from the blood tests and stuff. Once in a while, I sneak in and play Tetris.
So how come you know so much about this place? Is your mom a volunteer?
Well, when she's not working. I come down here on my own, mainly. Almost every night after school. Unless I have to go to the hospital for my treatment.
You have it too?
Yeah. Come on, I'll show you some more stuff.
That kid, Danny, he's really something. I mean, if he could be the way he is, I guess I should... I told him that I might come back one day next week, after school.
Did I hear something about school?
Yeah, but don't make a big deal out of it, okay?
Me? Why would I do that? Be there first thing in the morning. Thank you for calling.
The truth, remember? Always the truth.
Your test Wednesday. Your white blood cell count is up.
Way up?
Way up.
We'll increase the dosage of the interferon. That should bring the white blood cell count back down to normal for the time being.
That's it? I was so scared.
You might start experiencing more side effects.
Well, she had that before, the shivering and the fever.
It was awful.
I know, Nisa. But interferon is an extremely potent drug, and you're taking a large dosage. I wish I could make the side effects disappear. But I can't. Just hang in there.
If he doesn't call me tonight, I'm gonna die. I swear to God, I'll die. Anissa, you're back.
Yeah, here I am.
I feel like a real jerk.
It's okay. You guys can talk about regular stuff in front of me. I'm still interested in guys.
You know, it's really great you're back and everything. I got a class.
Me too.
I'll see ya.
Don't they know it's not contagious?
Give them a chance, Anissa.
They're scared.
Of me? No. What's happened to you? If this thing could happen to you, it could happen to any of us.
You guys are supposed to be my friends.
We are. Really?
Yeah, right.
Hi, guys.
How you doing?
Hey.
Hi. So, Anissa, we organized a rally and a test drive at your high school. I thought maybe you could say a few words to the kids.
No way. I'm not good at making speeches.
Oh, no, no. This is not a speech. You just tell them what's happening. Right, Danny?
Right. The first time I got up in front of people, it was at church. I was sweating. I felt sick. But then when I started to talk, it was like they really wanted me to do good. I mean, I could feel love coming right at me. Does that sound dumb?
No. But church is different. At school, the kids don't care about any of this stuff. They're all into their own thing, you know? They don't understand.
Really help if you spoke to him, Anissa?
I could go with you.
Why don't you do the speech?
It's your school.
You know, I gotta tell you, you never know. Because of what you say, somebody in the audience could volunteer to be tested. They could turn out to be a match for Danny.
I'd do the same for you. For sure.
Okay. Okay. I'll do it.
Great.
I'm telling you, it's a waste of time. Nobody's going to show up. They're not interested. All they care about is cars and boys and... Wow. Look at them.
It's okay.
Here, take this.
What is it?
It's my lucky stone. Right, Mom?
That's right. He found it on the beach when he was a baby. He's had it ever since.
See how it feels real smooth and warm when you hold it? It makes you feel real good by just touching it. It's magic.
Magic, huh? I could use a little of that.
Come on, folks. Let's go.
Students of Walnut High, your classmate, Anissa Ayala.
Thank you. It's hard for me to get up here and ask my friends for help. I don't know what plans you guys have for the future. But me? I always wanted to ride one of those gondolas in Venice. I've never done that. I've always wanted to go scuba diving. I've never done that. I'd like to learn to speak French. I haven't done that. And one day, I'd like to meet a really nice guy and get married and walk down the aisle in my dad's arm and watch my mom get all teary-eyed. Those are the things in the future for me. But unless somebody out there, maybe one of you, unless somebody out there donates the marrow that's going to save my life, then I have no future. And maybe it won't be a match for me, but you'll be a match for somebody else, like my friend Danny. Or the thousands of other people who are trying to beat this awful disease, who need your help. And we will beat it. We will. I will.
Well, I'll have to get 10 copies. I mean, one for Mama, one for Leonard, one for Vicky.
We'll frame one for the office.
Yeah. A&M Precision. Oh. Okay, I'll tell her. Is there anything that we can do? Okay. That was Rita Wilson, Danny's mother. He's in the hospital. She just wanted me to let Anissa know. It's funny how you can fool yourself. But it's always there.
I should have never given you my magic stone. Big mistake.
There. Now you'll be out of here in no time.
Yeah. The doctor said I should be out in a week or so.
See?
Anissa?
What?
Nothing.
Come on.
Well, if I were maybe 4 or 5 years older, would you go to a show with me or something?
Sure. Sure I would.
You got good taste, girl.
Extension 321. Thanks for waiting with me. It gets kind of lonely sometimes.
Where's your husband?
No such beast. He left for greener pastures when Danny was little.
No other family?
Plenty of family, but they're all back east.
That's gotta be tough on you.
Yeah, but I got my boy. He's a fighter. He's gonna make it. All he needs is a donor. That's what I pray for. Every morning, every night. Yeah, I think I'm being hurt.
Yeah.
How do you handle it?
Well, I keep real busy. Abe and I had these brochures made up about Anissa, and when they're done, I'm gonna go around to a lot of places and make speeches and let people know how easy it is to be a donor.
Sounds good.
Yeah. And, I'm gonna try and have a baby.
Maybe we'll both be hurt.
I don't know what your father's up to. He was being very mysterious on the phone, but he said that we should eat with Adam, that he had some important business.
Get out of your grass skirts!
The old man's finally flipped his cook.
Noon. Bye.
Ow! He asked me out! He asked me out! Oh, God!
I'll never know why you make me feel this way. With you by my side, I'll love you every day. Because of you, lady, my love won't pass away. Don't know how to tell you, girl, that my love is here to stay.
Here to stay with you,
my pretty lady. You will see through, so forever and a day, I'll love you always.
I'll love you always.
I'll love you always.
Oh, Mary. Mary.
What?
It's 2 a.m. They just came in.
Who?
And Lisa and Brian. Let's go downstairs.
Hey, wait.
For what? My niece is just a kid.
Abe, we were just kids, you and me.
That was different. We were getting married.
Abe, Anissa may never have the chance to get married.
Don't say that.
What if time runs out for her like it did for Danny?
It can't.
Yes, it is. Oh, hold on a sec. Abe, it's a reporter from the Los Angeles Chronicle. She saw the story in the Tribune and she wants to do a piece on us.
It'll be good publicity for the blood drive next week.
Yeah. Hello, Miss Carter. Why don't you come by this afternoon? The Ayala case focuses on the question of the parent's ability to do what is in the best interest of the baby when their decisions are being influenced by the imminent life or death of an existing child.
How much potential risk and suffering can parents demand of one child for the benefit of another child? What the hell is all this about?
We talked about what little risk there would be.
Well, what right have they got?
Look, Abe, it's probably going to blow over. It's just a newspaper article.
All I'm saying is that we're doing everything we can in order to save our daughter. And no parent's going to just stand by and wait for their child to die and do nothing. That's all I'm saying. No comment, huh?
Abe, this is crazy. I can't believe the questions that they're asking. We have to do something.
What? What can we do? Tell me.
I feel that my baby is a gift from God.
She's our miracle, and people have no right to say that what my parents are doing is bad.
From the medical aspect, it's a point of fact that donating marrow is completely safe, even for a baby.
Everyone's jumping the gun about the transplant anyway. We don't even know yet if our baby will be a match for Anissa.
But whether she is or she isn't, we couldn't love her or want her any more than we already do. All of us, our whole family. That's all we have to say.
Thank you for coming, ladies and gentlemen. No more questions.
The child was conceived so that she could serve as a bone marrow donor for her sister, who is dying of leukemia. But the concept of having a baby for the purpose of a transplant has many ethicists and lawyers concerned.
If you ask me, it's an absolutely terrifying thought that we are growing human beings in order to harvest organs.
My primary argument with this whole scenario is that we are seeing humans used as spare parts. Well, in my view, this is a slight tinge of cannibalism about it.
It does seem to me that we are on a
slippery slope. Turn it up. I can't watch this.
How can he say that? Hey, what are you guys doing home so early? Is everything okay?
I went to the mall.
And everybody kept coming up to me and asking me stuff about the baby. I just can't handle it, Mom. Ignore it, mija. They're just curious. I'll get it. Hello? Yes, it is. I see. Okay. Yes. Yes, thank you for calling. Abe? Abe, would you come in here, please? Anissa, Brian?
It's not a mom.
What's wrong? It's a baby. My Anissa. They just got back the rest of the test results. She's a match. She's a perfect match.
I feel like she's mine, like she's my little girl.
I have something for you.
A graduation present?
No. Well, you gonna look inside?
I need some time to think.
What's to think about? What? Okay? It's okay?
It's my leg, a cramp. It's from the interferon.
Oh, it's okay. It's okay. It'll be better soon. It'll be fine. I think it's time to do the transplant.
Because of the side effects of the interferon?
No. Because I've looked at your latest test results, and I don't think we can wait any longer, Anissa.
The baby. She'll be okay?
I've spoken to Dr. Britico. He says Marissa's ready. She'll be just fine.
Then I'm ready too.
Yeah.
Well, what happens now?
Once Anissa checks into the hospital, the next 12 days are going to be like a countdown towards the transplant. She'll receive massive doses of radiation and chemotherapy to kill all the diseased marrow so she'll be prepared for the transplant. Unfortunately, this process also destroys the immune system. We'll take good care of her. Now, on the 12th day, Marissa will be brought into another section of the hospital. We'll extract the healthy marrow from her.
She won't feel anything.
She'll be asleep. The whole thing will be over for her in 20 minutes. There'll be no stitches and no cutting. Just a band-aid or two on her hip when she wakes up.
She's so tiny.
Anissa, I want you to understand that I couldn't have continued on this case with a clear conscience if I thought that the baby would be used, that she wouldn't be cared for or loved for who she was rather than for what she might be providing. Okay.
Okay.
Oh, look, you have a nice view of the garden.
Will I have to wear a mask like that?
For about 3 months after the transplant, except when you're alone. What's in there?
You know, clothes, shoes, stuff. I mean, I'm going to be here for a while.
I'm afraid this is all you're going to need.
It isn't it?
What do you mean, baby?
We can't turn back now. They've killed everything inside me. If the transplant doesn't work...
It'll work. We've come this far, Mia. God won't let us down now.
Mama, just in case. I want to tell you that I love you and Daddy so very, very much. My life has been great. And Marisa, she's a little part of me.
Yes.
So if I die, when you see her, hold her. You'll hold me.
Your baby from the transplant?
I don't know. Just leave us alone.
How many hours of the operation on little Marissa take?
20 minutes. She'll be fine.
Any second thoughts about the ethical implications of the operation?
What is the percentage of...
We have how does it feel knowing both your daughters
no.
Lives are in jeopardy?
Oh, my God.
What are the daughters up to?
Because of press are there, Dr. Foreman arranged for us to use a side entrance.
All right. Abe, I want you to sit down and try to relax, okay? Look, you just take it from somebody who's been through this before. My own wife.
We're relaxed.
Yeah, can't you tell?
Extracted the marrow. Marissa's doing fine. just so you know exactly what's happening now. The marrow is being taken to Anissa. It'll drip through the IV into a catheter in her chest. No matter how often I see this, I never fail to marvel at the sheer wonder of it. I mean, of one person being given new life by another person. Anissa will remain in isolation for about 3 weeks, during which time, if everything works as we hope it will, her body will direct Marissa's healthy stem cells to all the right spots, where they'll make new blood cells.
Thank you.
Marisa? How's Marisa?
She's just fine, Mia.
And livelier than ever.
Hey, here they come.
Could you stop and say a few words for Channel 3 News?
You're right after those, aren't you? Did you ever think you might lose Anissa? Has her illness affected your relationship in any way? Please, can you speak to us?
Do you have anything better to do? Welcome home, baby. You know, Grandma's coming in a little while. She's bringing Marisa.
We scrubbed your room.
I took out all those stuffed animals. God knows what germs they have.
I rented you some great videos.
You want something to eat?
No, thanks.